As you can see, we have skipped over to page 352 because there is one little thing I want you to know about, and that's in this chapter. And this is a chord that has not 1-2-3 notes, but 1-2-3-4 notes. You see it here also. We took a triad and added a fourth note, a third higher, and that is called a seventh chord. And there's a whole lot of different seventh chords that exist in this world, and you do not need to know them all, but I do want you to be familiar with this one, which is called the dominant seventh chord, because that is really important in a lot of, well, in all kinds of music. It's a very commonly used thing, so I didn't want you to see this and not know what it meant. We don't have an assignment on it, but you can read this on page 352, describing what's going on. And when it occurs on a chord with a Roman numeral, just add a 7 on it like this, if it's root position. It can be in inversions too. We're not going to worry about that quite yet, okay? Just be aware that a seventh chord is like a triad, but it has 4 notes instead of just 3 notes. And in the chord symbols that we saw, it would look like this. A7, C-sharp 7, F7. All those mean seventh chords. And hopefully, another time, we can learn about all the different kinds of seventh chords there are. But just now be aware that a seventh chord is a chord that has 4 notes instead of just 3 notes.